You said that over and over time ago. I've heard you. I'm not a child anymore. I know whose daughter I am.
I know, but I still have to talk to you.
You're making me nervous already, Mom.
You don't have to be my darling. Just take care in all you do.
Alright.
Let me speak up that call.
Mom, it's just day.
Pick it up.
Fine. Hello, Dave. Yeah, I'll be on my way shortly. I'm coming. I'll be right there on time. Just relax. I'm coming. Oh, okay. Alright. Mom, I think I have to be on my way.
Alright.
He's already calling.
Just take care.
I will.
I told you before, be careful.
Okay.
By the way, so sorry.
And the wealthy, right?
I'm gonna miss you.
I'll miss you too, Mom.
Alright,
take care of yourself.
Take care too.
Bye. Take care of Daddy, okay?
Alright.
Love you.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, make sure you call me when you get
to I'll do this. That, okay?
Alright.
Alright, bye.
What's wrong with him? People beg everywhere.
This one looks familiar.
So?
Can you do me a favor?
What?
Can you help me give him some money? And when you're doing that, help me check if he has a mark by his eyebrow here, please.
I know you're not a fancy man, but not to an old man or a beggar for that matter. You are very funny.
No, not really. Just that. This one looks familiar. Can you help me check, please? I just want to be sure. This one looks familiar. I'm certain. Please.
I'll just do it for you.
Thank you. I actually would have gone by myself, but if it's the person I'm thinking, I'm sure he will recognize me. Please.
Okay.
Please, thank you very much. Thank you very
Joyce, have you asked David?
No. How could I?
Then why worried if you cannot ask him?
Do you think I should?
I don't think David will bite you if you do.
Maybe I should just call him and ask him like a joke. But I don't know what he's going to say. David, you have to do something about this.
What do you want me to do? Arrest him?
This is becoming unbearable. If my parents get to know about this, especially my dad, he wouldn't approve of this union.
Why are you talking like that? You make me look irresponsible. See, I'm in this relationship because I was made. And that is a sign of responsibility.
He that doesn't provide for the family.
Will you stop? Stop, please. You know my hands. I pay my tithe. I give 10% to my dad. I give my mother 10%. I give both the same church. I support my friends and brothers. And I live on just 30%. I'll save the rest for our marriage.
Maybe that 10% isn't enough. Maybe it's not just enough for him.
Oh, what? Is he God? If God will not take more than 10%, I will give to no man more than 10%.
Let's just try and put heads together. In the place where I work, scandal like this kills career.
Scandal?
This is how scandal starts. This is how it starts. And I cannot put my family, my life, everything, my career, because of this. I can't put it in stake.
So, you're not putting your family and safe place before you?
Hello, Dad. Good morning, Dad.
Hello. Good morning, son.
Daddy, you are destroying my joy with this action of yours.
My son, I am no longer doing that trick just as I promised you. I will only sit with them and collect my due as a union member. Don't you get that?
Dad, please! Don't associate yourself with them at all, please!
How? Are we not families?
Of course I know we are! But it's affecting me now, Dad!
Don't be ungrateful, son. This is the same work I use in sending you to school. Because you have gotten a certificate now, you are not insulting me.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm not insulting you. Look, we will give you more money after we get married, please.
Why not now?
Dad, we are not married yet. See, Dad,
Joyce
ain't more than me. Because of the type of work she does. Daddy, she does advertisements and modeling. She will be affected by this action of...
Look. If you have money to give me now. If not, I will worry you. I am not stealing. I am only begging. Since Renway laid me off, this is the only trade I know how to do best. And it pays.
Dad, okay. I promise you. I will give you more money. But please stop the begging. Please, it's embarrassing me.
I pray that God should bless you with plenty money so that you can give to me. To take care of myself and be content with.
I promise you, Dad, once we get married, you will see the difference.
When I see the difference, then I will stay at home. For now, let me do the work I know best to do.
Dad!
Good day, viewers. Welcome to today's edition of Decisions. We have a wonderful topic before us today. And the topic isn't just wonderful in itself, but we also have a very surprising guest. Like, there's love in the studio right now. I'll soon get married, so don't worry. I'm not out of the picture at all. And we have a Mr. and a Mrs. in the house, and they're looking beautiful. First of all, I'm sure you know her. She's one of our wonderful guests that have come here before, Dr. Annie Gala. She's a lecturer at the College of Education Warri, and she's also a child evangelist. Good day, Ma.
Good day.
It's good
ma.
To see you again.
Thank you. Glad to be here again. Too.
All right, Ma. And then we have our wonderful husband, and they've been plain love, as we say in the studio. He is the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academics of the State University, big name, is Professor Anigala. Good day, sir.
It's a pleasure meeting you.
It's good to have you on set, sir.
Thank you.
With your lovely wife.
Yes, yes, yes. I'm the best woman in the world.
Okay, I'm not jealous. I will just pretend like I didn't hear that and would go ahead to talk. All right. The one back too many. What's on ground right now? The question is, first of all, people ask, young people ask them, how much can you take for love? You know, how much can you give for love? So persons, they lose contact with their parents, their family, their friends because of love, and on and on and on. So the first question we're going to talk about today is, can a person's family background do a potential damage?
Yes, it can. Depending on the effect. Are you talking about it's having to do with a psychological damage on the individual that the person now decides, you know, to carry over in terms of his or her relationship with others? So first and foremost, is the individual in question. If the background has had a negative effect, psychological effect on him, then you discover that it's also going to have a negative effect when the person wants to relate with others.
Okay.
But ordinarily, for somebody who is well brought up, the background, depending on what you mean by background anyway,
yeah,
should not affect the person and should not affect his love relationship.
Okay, but can he also affect a person's job reputation?
Again, it depends on the type of background you're talking about.
Okay.
Was the person born in a silver spoon? Or was it, is the person from a
wretched
background?
Yes,
a poor background? If the person is from a poor background, I don't see any reason why it should affect his or her job profile.
Okay,
I want to look at it in a different way. If the person is from a background of violence, for example, definitely it will affect his marriage. Because a young boy, for instance, growing up in a place where the man is always boxing the wife, the father is always boxing the mother, definitely such child can grow up to become a wife boxer in the future. So it will affect his marriage, that kind of background.
What about his job status? Like, is there any way, I'm trying to relate how, whatever program you go from, even if your father was a rapist, your father was a criminal, how can it affect you doing your job? Well, you have your certificate, you have your qualifications, it's obvious that you don't have it on paper, you have it on head.
Yeah.
You're already working, how, and then they get to find out that this is what you're doing. Can it affect it?
Well, again, I want to look at the individual. If you look at so many persons today and we decide to trace our background, you discover that very many of us may even come from worse background.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm looking at it at the individual level. If you are somebody who is so mindful of what the public will say about you, and you are, you know, out of pride or whatever the social status that you confer on yourself, yes, it will. But if you are the person who derives strength from your background, this is my background. Because I come from this poor background, I'm going to use that as a stepping stone to excel so that others will know that irrespective of the type of background you come from, you can make it in life.
Yeah.
Then it becomes a source of strength.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we are looking at it from the two perspectives.
Okay. Now, we've established that it can and it cannot.
Yes.
Depends on who you are. Now, should we allow it affect when you have a choice, you know, because for the girl in question, Joyce is her name, people are talking and she's listening to talk and she heard that this happened, because she, first of all, the first scenario it happened was she walked into a potential father-in-law begging. She didn't say anything because she wanted to believe it was, okay, it can't be him, it can't be my father-in-law. Okay, then she heard people talking. Because of what she heard, she had to confront her fiancé. So should we allow it? Is this something we should allow affect our potential relationship now, not our job anymore?
You see, there's whether we like it or not, the society will put pressure on you on several things, several areas. It is the pressure you allow that will put you down.
Yeah.
So I don't think, you know, it's logical to allow such things to affect us. It means we cannot have control of our lives. We begin to control our lives with what people say. It means such persons cannot stand for anything because you don't have something you are really standing for. We shouldn't allow such at all. Yes, to affect us.
Okay. The next question I'm going to ask is Joy's decision to end the relationship if the father does not restrain. Not also forget she's in the advertising industry, she's a model, so she's, I think, her industry is the one that has to do with not more of what you can do, like not more mental progress, but physical and character wise and all. Okay, so a decision to end the relationship. Because of that, like, I'm sure she might have given this guy an ultimatum. Is it baseless?
It's, to me, I feel it's baseless. Except she has other things that we have not known. Because that will not affect her. The boy is not... The boy in question, is he portraying such traits?
Yeah, not the one begging.
It's not the one begging. So I don't see how that should affect her her career or whatever. It's because maybe she's least giving into what people say or do. So what, like what we expect, like what he said, you know, she should be able to, you know, portray to the public that, look, though we have this background, we can do, we can bring out something better from the lineage, you know, since she's now going to partner with that young man. We can bring out something better from the lineage. The boy is not the one begging. So I don't see how that should affect her career, except she has other things that, that she's not saying, but she wants to use her as a cover up to break the relationship.
That's Nigel, ask the question. Does she really love him?
Okay.
Love is sacrificial. Okay? So one would expect that she would even derive strength from it and use it as an opportunity to encourage others to become better.
Yeah.
That irrespective of your background, you can make it in life. So fundamentally, I think something is wrong. Yeah. As far as I'm concerned, it's baseless.
Well, we'll just put a pause on it and come back after a short break. Don't go anywhere. Stay close. You can just go down, look down your screen right now. Our Facebook address, Twitter handle, and all of that is down there. Go ahead, like, and put your comments, ask your questions. Stay there. We'll be right back. Thank you. Don't do that. I will do that. I know. So, what should be the base of a good relationship? I mean, what makes it last? Like, at least you are a proof of it. You won't just be seeing what you...
It's not like it's magic, but I have to pick this up, sacrifice on my needs, and then also not the type of...
She had already planned an outing with the family, with her husband and two kids, and then as soon as she stepped into the office, her boss told her to get to be prepared.
Welcome back. It's Two Decisions, and today's topic is One Beg Too Many. Before we went on a break, Professor Annie Gala was he taught something that we need to go back on love. First of all, you're both here in the house. How long have you been married for?
Not too long ago, just 29 years now.
I was going to say, what happened? When you said not too long ago,
just 29 years.
Someone lose the wife and you have to marry, and you will form a divorce.
Just 29.
People can't count five in this present situation. No. I think it's enough to be celebrated.
Because like, I'm expecting that.
We are still on honeymoon. Not come back, and I don't intend to come back.
I refuse to be jealous. I can't see them, I can't hear them. We are just I'm walking right now. Okay. Well, on that, people do not actually know the base of what a relationship should be anymore. So there are threats everywhere. There are what's it called? If you don't do this, I will do this. If you don't do this, I will do this. If you don't do that, I will do that. I know. So what should be the base of a good relationship? I mean, what makes it last? Like, at least you are a proof of it. You won't just be saying what you don't know. I know, yes.
Yeah, there are two things. One, love. And then two, if the relationship is founded on the Lord Jesus Christ. Those are the two basic things. Once you're able to get them right, because...
What are the foundations?
Yes, the foundation is Christ. He's going to be the one to provide the nutrient to lubricate the home, okay? And then if it's founded, when you have that, and you also have, you love the person, you have that deep affection for that person, you see, you always have that desire to see how you are going to make the person to become better in life. You do not see the person as a liability. You see the person as an asset. You look at the potentials in that person. In which case, the person may even be down, but, you know, through your efforts, through the interaction between the two of you, you help the person to become better.
Okay.
In our relationship, we have helped each other to become better. But because it's also anchored on the Lord, it makes it easier for us.
Okay, I would like Ma to answer this question, still on this, so you could pick it up. Obviously, Sarah was not a prof years ago when you first married him. I don't know what background is from, but when so hard to see potential, what do you do? Like, when the potential just, everybody is having potential these days, you know? Like, I have potential. So what do you, how do you differentiate potential from potential? If you know what I mean.
Okay, like you said back again, you see, I didn't see any. And I saw Jesus Christ in him. And because I saw Jesus in him, I knew Jesus had potential. Yes.
I knew that.
If Jesus is in him and Jesus has all the potentials you can think of, the one I desired, I believe that he would have it.
Ma, but Jesus is not a young man these days.
Yeah, you see, that's the
talking,
problem.
What speaking brother, yes. Battering sisters.
That's the problem. You know, people live in mass these days. And if you talk about love, I was going to say something. If you say you really love, love tolerates. Love carries a lot of things with it. But these days, I don't know what people say they have. Maybe it's lust and not love. So that is the problem.
Okay.
You know, it's not there. It's just the counterfeit of it. So this is what, you know, this is the secret of our relationship, really. It is not based on any... After all, when I met you, you were living in a room and parlor.
Yeah, oh, was it even of a Roman palace? Yes, it was a Roman palace.
Yeah, Roman palace. And could count the number Roman of trousers.
Yes. You know,
but like
she has to encourage us now.
Yes.
She
has
to encourage us. If you look at those things, you won't go anywhere.
Yeah.
If you look at what you are seeing, you won't go anywhere. But I was looking beyond that. I saw a lot in him. You know, through Jesus who was in him, who then I saw in him, and who is still in him now, which is still keeping me going. You know, anything I desire in him, I just talk to him. Talk to God about it. And the thing just starts manifesting. You know, it's not like it's magic, but I have to do some sacrifice on my knees. And then also, not the type of, how do you call it now? The over sharp, the way they say it now.
The computer.
I just want it and want it. If it's not coming, then you start looking somewhere. No,
there
has to be patience, long suffering. All these things have to come.
Before we get too mushy and start crying in the institute, I'm getting really emotional right now. Let's just go back to job. Enough on love business. Okay, is there any job worth competing over a valid relationship? Doesn't have to be marriage. You know, a lot of persons are young and are in relationships that are heading towards there. So, is there any job that should be able to, like, you should come up the scale that when you wait with your relationship, it's almost like you can almost wait over your relationship. Any job.
If your job is more important to you than your relationship, you have missed it.
Somebody once said something. He said, when the chips are down, your job won't take care of you.
Yeah.
Your family will. Take, for instance, somebody who had an accident or sick and could not be in the job for close to 6 months, and the job they were tolerating, 6 months they were paying. After 6 months, they came and said, well, we're sorry, can't continue, we have tried. And everybody saw that they have tried, and then they now give you some stipends to lay you off and you go. But your family will be there for you for life.
They don't go anywhere.
They don't go anywhere. So anybody who plays premium on the job more than the relationship has not really understood the basis of relationship.
Okay.
I agree with you 100%. Yes.
Then, okay, we're wrapping up already because of our time. Would it be morally, like, the young man trying to pay off his father? Is it morally right? Like, what do you think he should do at this point?
Pay off his father for what?
Because that's what we call it, the black man pay off.
The young man was too considerate. No, I'm just being honest. I mean, what's the basis? If I know I should, you know, try to help in taking care of my parents, because the Bible says so.
Yeah.
Let's look at it from the biblical point of view. But it should not become a source of blackmail.
Yeah.
I'll be able to provide for you as much as is within my power.
Oh.
Okay? If you want to turn it into a source of blackmail, I will cut it off. I will not go ahead. You go ahead and do whatever you want to do. That's why we are saying that they should not allow it, you know, to affect their relationship.
Yeah.
If the man wants to blackmail us, we'll try to see how we can turn it around. For goodness sake, we're into advertorials. Okay? We can make an advert from it. And look at the person is begging. And then you say, this is the background from where I come, and I've been able to build on that, and I've been able to make it. Therefore, anybody can make it.
But there's even an economic value to this.
Yes, to that. Yes. And once you do that and the man sees himself there, what is he going to say? Will he be able to demand for an additional? So, this depends on us.
At one point, I'm saying, you know, the boy loves the father. And he doesn't want to lose both ways. He wants to see how he can carry both. Yes. Where he will not offend the father and at the same time keep his relationship. So that was what I believe he was trying to negotiate with him. And say, oh, daddy, I will increase this thing. You know, just keep up the... But the man wasn't seeing, wasn't being reasonable. The boy was just trying to... You know, he loves. He loves his family. He doesn't want to just keep off because I want a relationship. Let me just lay off my parents. He wants to see how he can maintain balance. But when the balance was not coming up, do the obvious.
Okay, finally.
Take his relationship.
Finally. It's obvious. We've already faulted that. We've already said that this relationship is faulted.
Yes.
So if the father is not... is not responding, and the lady wants to walk away, what should David do? Because I'm sure she could also give him as an ultimatum to cut out of his family. In as much as on a good day, all things being equal, because of what the father is doing, that seems like a very, like, okay, let me stay from them, I need to. But that the lady is pushing enough, and we're saying there's a fault there, should he listen to her, walk away from his family and stay with her, or should allow her go?
Personally, I would want to allow her go. Because such persons with such kind of
ultimate,
yes, she will want to be in control of his life in future. Because the way we know it, the man is the head of the home any day. So if that is a pointer to the kind of wife she will be when they are married in future.
And more again, ultimatums.
Yes, giving ultimatums. I don't think there is real love there. So though it's painful for that moment, you should let go.
Okay. It's a difficult proposal. Because even if you decide to lean to the family, you are also in for trouble. Because you are going to be daddy's boy, as it were. Because your father will also ensure that you do not have, you know, peace of mind.
Yeah.
For every situation that comes up, he will want to manipulate you. Because he knows that once he does that, he will be able to get you.
Yeah.
So it's a difficult situation. Whereas I agree with my wife that he should let go. He should walk away. I would also want a situation where he would want to let him try to discuss with Joyce first.
Okay.
And make her understand, you know, the type of background and what is going on. And let's see whether she will be able to appreciate the situation.
Yeah.
Because communication, again, it's also very important.
Making her know that the culture, yes,
the culture of the environment, and that they can also actually use it as a source of strength
for themselves. Yeah.
Okay? So, at the end of it all, if she is able to appreciate that type of that type of situation, then let them go ahead. But if not, I will put it, if I were David, I will put it straight to my father.
Mm. That's okay?
Yes, put it straight to my father, what he's trying to do. And that I will not succumb to it.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I will also make this lady understand that if she truly loves me, she will be ready to sacrifice.
Yeah.
So if the sacrifice is not there, then something is wrong.
It's time to go.
And I can begin to chart a new path.
Yeah. Thank you very much. I've actually really enjoyed my chat with both of you. I've learned not just... this was not a studio job. It was personally for me. I had a lot to learn. Thank you very much for being such an inspiration.
Thank you.
All right, I'm sure you enjoyed everything and you've learned a lot. Don't forget to ask your questions and make a comment on our social media handles. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next week, same time, same station. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye.